Welcome to Basketball U. If you're new to Basketball U, make sure you slam dunk that subscribe button. And just to make sure you don't miss a thing, make sure you tap that notification bell right after you hit that subscribe button. What's going on, Basketball U? You. Welcome to another edition of Role Players, where we highlight the unsung heroes that you hear about while they're making noise playing, but forgotten about once they no longer grace the floor with their presence. And while you're at it, be sure to hit the thumbs up. Today, we are talking about a role player who was a high-flying McDonald's All-American who made the jump to the NBA without playing in the NCAA. He was a six-time NBA All-Star and made the All-NBA second team a few times in his career. Basketball U family, we would like to present the one and only Shawn Kemp. Kemp attended Concord High School in Elkhart, Indiana. At the prestigious BC All-Star Camp on his first day, Kemp outplayed highly regarded prep star Terry Mills, a four-year varsity starter. He was considered to be one of the top four or five players nationally his senior year and led his team to the state championship finals. Kemp ended his high school career as Elkhart County's all-time leading scorer and the owner of Concord's career, single-game, and single-season scoring records. Despite his achievements and accolades, Kemp was bypassed for the title of Indiana Mr. Basketball. Woody Austin won the award that year instead. There has been some speculation that Kemp was purposely passed over for the award because he verbally committed to the University of Kentucky and did not express interest in staying in state to play college basketball. Woody Austin committed to Purdue University. Kemp was selected to the 1988 McDonald's High School All-American team, considered one of the best classes of all time, along with such notable players as Alonzo Mourning. Kemp scored a team-high 18 points for the West in a losing cause. The final score was 105-99 in favor of the East. Kemp, playing for the Concord High School varsity basketball team in 1987-88 during his senior year, Kemp signed a national letter of intent to play basketball at the University of Kentucky. Kemp failed to score the minimum of 700 on the Scholastic Aptitude Test, or SAT, and was forced to miss his freshman year under the NCAA's Proposition 48 rules. Jim Hahn, Kemp's high school coach, did not like the idea of Kemp being in Kentucky without playing basketball, saying to have Shawn in a college environment without basketball, the one thing he loves was, I felt, a big mistake. It even crossed my mind to advise him to go right into the NBA, and the only thing that stopped me was the fact that so few players have done it. Kemp decided to enroll at Kentucky. However, he left the team in November 1988 after he was accused of pawning two gold chains that had reported stolen from his teammate, Sean Sutton, the son of then Kentucky head coach Eddie Sutton. Sean Sutton did not press charges, but Kemp transferred to Trinity Valley Community College in Texas. After a semester at TVCC, where he did not play, 19-year-old Kemp declared himself eligible for the 1989 NBA Draft. The Seattle Supersonics drafted Kemp in the first round of the 1989 NBA Draft. Although extremely athletic, Kemp was the youngest player in the NBA at that time and struggled to find his place. In his first season in Seattle, Kemp was mentored heavy by teammate Xavier McDaniel. As the season progressed, so did Kemp's skills, which propelled him into stardom. Kemp began to find his place in the NBA as a star during his second season with the Supersonics. Together with Gary Payton, Eddie Johnson, Ricky Pierce, and Nate McMillan, they became a highly successful squad. After Kemp's second NBA season, he picked up the name Rain Man after the Supersonics' announcer, Kevin Calabro, saw a poster with the name and thought it fitting to add to his radio broadcasts. One of Kemp's signature highlights was a 1992 playoff game against Golden State, where he memorably threw down a vicious slam dunk on Austin Lister. Kemp played for the U.S. national team in the 1994 FIBA World Championship in Toronto, winning the gold medal. He also appeared in an MTV Rockin' Jock annual celebrity basketball game. Kemp's career record in 1995-96, when he and Peyton led the Supersonics to a franchise record 64 wins in their first NBA Finals appearance since 1979. They faced Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls, who were coming off an NBA record of 72 wins. The Supersonics pushed the heavily favored Bulls to 6 games before losing. In the finals, Kemp posted per game averages of 23.3 points on 55% shooting from the field, 10 rebounds, and 2 blocks. Shawn Kemp finished a close second in finals MVP voting, almost becoming the second player to win the award despite being from the losing team. During his time in Seattle, Kemp occasionally played during the offseason on an outdoor court in Seattle's Belltown District. Kemp signed a contract extension with the Supersonics in 1994. The league's collective bargaining agreement precluded any adjustment to that contract until October 1997. He was upset by the situation, but his agent, Tony Duke, understood that no negotiation was permitted. During this time, the Supersonics signed Jim McElveen to a 7-year, $33.6 million contract, exceeding Kemp's salary. Kemp threatened to refuse to play in the upcoming 1996-97 season and held out of training camp for 22 days. Despite his absence, Kemp helped lead the Supersonics to another 50-plus win season as they dispatched the Phoenix Suns in 5 games in the first round, only to lose to the Hakeem Olajuwon and Clyde Drexler-led Houston Rockets in a 7-game series in the second round of the NBA playoffs. Following the 1996-97 season, Kemp was part of a trade sending him to the Cleveland Cavaliers, Milwaukee Bucks forward Vin Baker to the Supersonics, and Terrell Brandon and Tyrone Hill from the Cavaliers to the Bucks. Kemp played 3 seasons with the Cavaliers while battling weight problems and often appeared to lack the drive that made him such a force in Seattle. Despite this, he posted career-high numbers for points per game in 1997-98 and led the Cavaliers to the NBA playoffs, where they faced the Reggie Miller-led Indiana Pacers. The Cavaliers lost to the Pacers in 4 games, despite Kemp averaging 26 points with 13 rebounds per game in the series. During the lockout-shortened 1998-99 NBA season, Kemp reportedly showed up to training camp weighing 280 pounds through Cleveland's then general manager, Wayne Embry, revealed that he was actually 315 pounds. Though unable to shed the weight, Kemp managed to average 20.5 points and 9.2 rebounds. Kemp was then traded to the Portland Trail Blazers after the 1999-2000 season. The trade reunited Kemp with Bob Whitsitt, who had originally brought Kemp to Seattle. However, Kemp's play began to decline significantly. The last few years of Kemp's professional basketball career were riddled with problems stemming from his weight, as well as drug and alcohol abuse. His first season in Portland ended early when he entered drug rehabilitation. After 2 seasons with the Blazers, Kemp was waived prior to the 2002-03 season. Kemp was signed as a free agent for the Magic and helped the Magic reach the playoffs despite the loss of starting small forward Grant Hill. During his season in Orlando, Kemp played in his 1,000th NBA game. In their first round series, the Magic took an early 3-1 lead before losing to the Detroit Pistons in 7 games. Following the 2002-03 season, Kemp was replaced by free agent forward Juwan Howard. During the halftime of the Sonics game in November 5th, 2006, Kemp was announced as one of the 16 members of the Supersonics 40-year anniversary team. After his active career, he tried to bring basketball back to Seattle. Kemp bought a mansion in Seattle in 2003 for $2.4 million, the year he retired from the NBA. In 2008, he listed the property for sale in the real estate market at a value of $3.7 million. The Ring Man left his mark on the NBA with his high-flying antics and his relentless energy and excitement he brought on the floor. Even though he came short of a championship, his role in the NBA inspired young people for years to come. Thank you, Ring Man. This is Basketball U. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And also, follow all of our social medias right there in the description to keep yourself up to date, as this channel will have a lot of basketball, a lot of players, and a lot of training and more information on how to play the game of basketball. Remember, someone's always working. Are you?